皮口袋或者是一些包装纸的一样东西，牛皮纸，披在身上的写的呢，这几句话差不多是我自己一生的事业追求。过去了30年，实际上呢，六四呢并没有走进历史。为什么没有走进历史？就是因为六四是什么，还搞不清楚。然后对这个问题的这种研究、挖掘、还原真相，都是一个非常非常大的禁区，被强有力的压制。所有关心这样事情的人，被认为是不合时宜的。
他们就站在那个巷子口，就拿枪就往里扫。当时感到真的那种怎么说，那种释放不出来，感觉在那种内心当中，看到这个军人的这种，就说你这是干嘛呢？是在哪儿呢？你以为你到了越南了，是吧？你这是在自己的首都啊！
就这被压死。
学生也在不断地喊着自己同学的名字，也在跟我们说，说北京市民，我们对不住你们，说我们，哎呦，感觉那种屈辱，那种压抑太难受了。后来我说，在你们面前都是北京市的市民，都是你们的父老乡亲，都是你们的兄弟姐妹。我说能够控制你的士兵别再开枪了。这件事情就是，如果大家对我的行为认可的多了，这个社会就是进步了。如果大家对我的否认多了，那说明这个社会还是很，怎么说呢，还是属于那种是一种社会倒退。为什么？因为我自认为89年六四我们所做的一切都属于正义的。
The following days, I went back to my school. At first, I tried to argue with my friends whether there was a crackdown, a military crackdown, or a massacre. And that our government told us it was just made up by the media of the West. But very soon, I shut up because we know that arrest was going on throughout the country.I think my body has a biological clock. The beautiful sunshine, the faces of the younger generation, it just reminded me of this time 30 years ago in 1989 when I and the young people of my generation, we took to the street with that much hope, thinking that we are going to make history. But history did not turn at that turning point in my country.
I am very proud for what I have done, and then I'm also, I feel also fortunate that I survived many when many others couldn't. So I will have to live with this survivor's guilt, and then with 30 years of slowly chewing that fact, and made me come clear and understood that I will probably have to live with that guilt for the rest of my life.Chinese people are still doing their best to try to remember what happened 30 years ago. sometimes remembrance is one of the most humble form of resistance.